So the treatment of scleroderma associated myopathy is still unknown. And the reason is because we just still don't know enough about the disease. But certainly, as I mentioned before, if someone has true overlap myositis, like polymyositis or dermatomyositis, then we would treat with immunosuppression, such as prednisone and other steroid-sparing agents, such as mycophenolate or methotrexate, or even IVIG if someone has severe weakness. But again, we don't know what is the best way for people who have scleroderma and muscle disease together. Although we don't know how best to treat on occasion, the workup, which includes potentially a biopsy, can help us determine if it is truly overlap myositis, or if it's a fibrosing myopathy, it would be a little bit of a different approach in terms of treatment. But again, it's really dependent on how the patient is doing clinically and what their clinical presentation is to determine the final kind of treatment algorithm for that patient. So it's going to be very patient specific. In scleroderma associated muscle disease and in myositis in general, also I think the multidisciplinary approach is very important, because if our patients have severe diaphragmatic weakness, we want to work with the pulmonologist to maximize treatment and even consider maybe pulmonary rehab for these type of patients. Another person that's very important in that kind of treatment plan would be a physical therapist or PM&R, physical medicine rehab, to adopt an exercise program. And lastly, I think when you have two overlap diseases like scleroderma and myositis, you want to really work closely with your rheumatologist plus other providers who can formulate a very specific treatment plan for your disease process. So for the treatment of scleroderma-associated muscle disease, if someone has inflammatory myositis, we typically use prednisone or immunosuppression. But high doses of prednisone have been associated with renal crisis, which is renal failure in patients with scleroderma. And so using high doses of prednisone can lead to this kind of adverse effect, including other adverse effects. But in this specific patient population, patients who have scleroderma, it's best not to use high-dose steroids. So it's very important that the patient holds hands with the rheumatologist to make sure that the steroid dose is adequate, but not too high, but certainly not too low. So it's going to be important to talk to your doctor about that as well. Patients with scleroderma-associated myopathy can certainly have flares. Flares can also be seen in myositis and lupus and all these other autoimmune conditions. So when someone is, if we are on treatment, certainly if someone's doing well, we say that they're in remission, kind of a chemical-induced remission from the medicines that we put them on. But if they get flares, that means they're getting muscle weakness despite you being on those medications. So you can get sudden rise in CK, sudden decrease in muscle endurance or weakness that may come up even after many months of treatment. But that's a little bit atypical. Typically, once we treat a patient, I feel like they tend to do pretty well. But that's why you have to have close communication with your rheumatologist, so that if you do feel weaker, we have to figure out, okay, is it because this is a flare or is it a progression of your disease? Because flare just means that you're feeling a little bit worse now and we can treat it with some medications and it should go away. Or is it there's a rapid progression of the disease that's just not halting despite all the treatment we're giving you? Patients who have scleroderma-associated muscle disease, it's not a predominantly recognized entity that scleroderma patients can get muscle disease. And so I feel like even physicians potentially can say and attribute your weakness and muscle fatigue and muscle pain, oh, this is all just from the autoimmune disease, and just say, it's all from the scleroderma, it's because your skin is getting tight. But we see that that's not the case. Certainly, that could potentially happen, but we shouldn't ignore those symptoms. if you have those symptoms and you have scleroderma, it shouldn't be brushed aside as saying that it's from your scleroderma only because you have contractures or because you have a skin tightness. But it should be heated, and it should result in, I believe, a thorough workup for muscle disease.